Hello dear learners, today we'll discuss assumption testing of linear regression using the software Stata. So here is your Stata software, and this is the data file, and our dependent variable is the stat marks, and our independent variable are study hour, IQ score, and learning disability. So these three are our independent variables, and stat marks is our dependent variable. So we'll perform the regression, and after performing regression, we'll see whether this results this fulfill the assumption of linear regression. So there are different assumptions of linear regression. First one that we'll discuss here is the assumptions that requires that there is no multicollinearity. That means your independent variables should not be highly correlated. So how can you perform this assumption test? There are two ways of performing multicollinearity test. One is by seeing the correlation value between the independent variables. So if the correlation value between the independent variables is greater than 0.7 or 0.8, there is a problem of multicollinearity. But here we'll show you the other way of identifying multicollinearity, that is called VIF, or variance inflation factor. So if your variance inflation factor is greater than 5, or in some cases it is greater than 10, then there is a multicollinearity problem. But if it is less than 5 or less than 10, depending on the subject, so there is no problem of multicollinearity. So I'd suggest to consider 5 as a standard value. Now, to test this assumption, definitely first you need to run this regression. So I'm typing the command, so reg, and my dependent variable, and then I'm putting my independent variable. Press enter, I'll get this result. And after getting this result, you go to the statistics option, and you see there is a linear model and related option. From here you need to go to the regression diagnostics, and then you need to select a specification test. And under the specification test, there are different options. You need to select this variance inflation factors for the independent variables VIF, and press OK, and you can see the VIF. So none of your VIF is greater than 5, so that means there is no problem of multicollinearity. The another way of finding the VIF without using this command, using this menu option, simply type the command. So when you run this regression, after running this regression, just write VIF and enter, so you will get this similar result. So without using this menu option, by using the command, you can also get this similar result. So this is the first assumption that we have tested here. Next, the assumption we'll test here is about the linearity. So to perform this test, you need to go to the graphics option, and there is two way graph, and under this graphing option, you need to, under this plot, you need to create. So from this create option, it is already selected as a scatter, so that's fine. And y is your stat marks, and definitely you need to check for one independent variable at a time. So first I will check with the study hour and press accept and OK. So you can see this is the graph that shows the linearity, and to get with the linear prediction option, after running this command, you again go there. Now this time you need to create another one, so create, and then you need to click fit plot. When you click the fit plot, it is already linear prediction, and y is your stat marks, x variable study hour, accept, okay. Now you can see this is the plotting. So from here you can see that there is positive linear relationship. So this fulfills the assumption of linearity. Next, we'll test our third assumption, that is the normality. So to test this normality, we can perform two types of analysis here. One is histogram, another one is Shapiro-Wilk test. So these two types of analysis we can do here. So normality means residuals in the models are random or normally distributed, right? So let's first see how can we do this using the graphical option, that is histogram. So you go to the graphics, and under the graphics you see there is a histogram option, so click histogram. Under this variable options, you need to put one variable at a time. So first I like to see for example stat marks, and it is continuous, and under the y-axis you click the frequency, and density, under the density plot you can put either normal density or kernel density. So I'm just pressing add normal density plot. Okay, so you can see the normality of your data. So it's slightly right skewed. So through this way, using the histogram option, you can find the normality assumption of your model. Another way of finding the normality is using the Shapiro-Wilk test. So we call Shapiro-Wilk test. So if your Shapiro-Wilk test shows a result that is p-value is not less than 5%, that means your data are not normal. But Shapiro-Wilk test p-value, if it is greater than 5%, then you can say yeah, your data is normally distributed. So how can you conduct this Shapiro-Wilk test? So to perform Shapiro-Wilk test, you write the command as swilk, and you need to put your variables here. So you can put all variables, press enter. So this is the p-value, and in all cases you can see that your data are not normally distributed because it is less than 1% or even 0.001. The last assumption test that we are conducting here is heteroskedasticity. That means the assumption is that data should not be heteroskedastic, or data should be homoskedastic, or there should be homoskedasticity in the data. That means the variance of residual terms should be equal. We can perform this through either plotting or using Brush-Pagan heteroskedasticity test. So first we'll use the Brush-Pagan heteroskedasticity test, and later we'll using the plotting option. So to run this test, definitely first you need to run this regression. So this is the regression command. So I got the regression result here, and after this regression you need to go to the statistics and linear model and related, and there is regression diagnostics. Under the regression diagnostics, specification tests. So under this you can see the first one, test for heteroskedasticity, and it is the Brush-Pagan, and use fitted value of the regression. So we have already performed the regression. I am using this fitted value. And if you previously not run this regression, in that case you need to we can define this variable individually, but I have already performed this regression, so I just click use the fitted value of the regression, and then you press the OK and you get the value, chi-square test value, and this is the probability value is 0.0000. So that's actually less than 1% or even 0.001. So if the p-value is less than your significance level, or for example if it is less than 0.05, that means there is a problem of heteroskedasticity. But if your p value is greater than 0.05, we can say there is no problem of heteroskedasticity. So you can see your p value, and it is statistically significant because it's less than 1%. So you can say there is heteroskedasticity problem. The another way of checking this using the plotting options, so residual versus fitted plotting. So after this regression you go to the graphics, and there is regression diagnostic plot. So this can be done through the residual versus fitted. So you click residual versus fitted. So right. So you go to the graphics again, regression diagnostic plot, residual versus fitted. And from here you press OK. So you can get residual against the fitted value. Another way of doing this is residual versus predictor. So you need to put your independent variable one at a time. So from the study hour, and then press OK. So you can also get against the fitted value. So through this option, so you can test the heteroskedasticity. And these are actually direct subcommand, so you can use this subcommand to get this result as well. So in this way we can check different assumptions of the regression model. Thank you.